So we're gonna use a CRT from a TV as audio amplifier tube, like an old radio with its speaker and output transformer. But we're gonna use the high voltage input of the CRT, and I'm using here a regular CRT from a 14 inches TV, color TV. So nothing fancy, this is the actual stuff you find quite easily. And I had this project in mind since some time, and I also did a pair of calculations to see if it was possible in terms of current stray capacitances. The calculations said in my mind that it wasn't much possible, but at the end it turned out it worked. The stray capacitances were not so high. The only problem is that it has a fairly low volume on the speaker, but it's perfectly audible. So what we have here on the bench? There's of course the CRT. And let's start with my newly made high voltage power supply, based on a flyback transformer. It's a 555 circuit. It has adjustable duty cycle. Here I've dirtied my finger, my nail. Awesome. Anyways, it's powered through a laptop power supply at 20 volts DC, three fake MOSFETs in parallel. Fake components are a must in my channel, maybe you know this. Three output voltages, focus screen, the classic ones, and the main one for CRTs experiments, etc. Anyways, I don't want to make a video about just this power supply here, because there are plenty of high voltage power supplies explained in my channel, so I don't want to add another 555 circuit with this one. Then there's this saltwater capacitor here, Leyden jar, nothing complex, it's just a beer bottle covered with sticky tinfoil and an electrode inside. The ground end is connected to ground here, and the other side is connected to the output of the flyback to make real DC for the audio section, because the flyback puts out pulsed DC and we don't need that. And usually to make DC a TV, a CRT has this graphite covering here that is often pretty clean. And this is usually connected to ground to make a capacitor and make DC for the phosphors. But considering that we need to let the anode swing with the audio, we need to disconnect this capacitor, but instead, to not let it stay floating, I've connected it to ground, but through this resistor here. That is a 90 megs resistor made with a zigzagged piece of paper painted with China ink. And you can see a video about a China ink resistor here that I made some time ago. And this makes the, let's say, anode capacitor be floating and swing with the audio oscillation. The output transformer instead, with its speaker, is all live in this place here. The speaker is live at high voltage, the transformer is live at high voltage. And I used a transformer and a C flyback from a tube TV, and it has some sort of, let's call it secondary, with 60 turns of enamored wire for the speaker. And the output, the high voltage wire is connected on the DC supply, and the other wire is connected instead on the input, the voltage input of the CRT. And this thing, this whole thing is live, I can touch it, and it's also separated from the CRT with this plastic box here, because the CRT has some metal inside. About the connections on the neck of the CRT, let's start with the filament supply here. This is provided by this power supply here at 6.3 volts, 2 watts, low current, kinda. Kinda any TV of this type draws like 2 watts on the filament, so you can guess the voltage by reading the power. Then there's a screen grid here that is connected naturally to screen grid. There's also a 2 nano 2 capacitor high voltage to stabilize the voltage on the screen grid. Focus grid here to focus grid from the flyback. The flyback is not the original flyback of the TV, but we are not much off because that's basically the same kind of stuff. Then there is grid 1 that is driven with the music on this setup here that I'm going to explain in a moment. Then there is this service ground here with some spark gaps inside, and it's connected to ground. The cathodes here on this red wire instead goes through this multimeter 2.5 milliamperes full scale to ground instead of the driving transistors, and the cathodes are all connected together because we don't need separate colors, etc. About grid 1, this wire here, this blue wire, instead of being connected to ground like in a regular TV, it's connected and driven by this transformer here. This is a regular mains transformer, and the primary is used as secondary, and one end is connected to ground, and the other end drives grid 1 through a 100k resistor that limits the positive side current on the grid and avoids some distortion. And the primary is used in the secondary is used as primary. It was 28 volts and is driven by this multi-purpose amplifier I made, mono amplifier. And we have an audio source with royalty free music. And this transformer is used to make a pretty high voltage for the grid 1 because this increases the volume a lot. Then we have a motor near the neck of the CRT with some magnets attached, and this magnet rotates at a fairly high speed, and this makes some rings on the screen instead of steady beams that can burn the CRT. And let's see it spinning. Whee! Okay. And you can see some effects made also thanks to this rotating magnet in this video here. And that's basically it. Ah! Sorry. Okay, let's try this thing. Motor on at 1.6 volts. Filament on, audio amplifier on, okay, and the final thing, high voltage on. Oh yeah, I forgot something. It makes also some cool effects with the grid 1 drive, varying brightness and shape. There's a bit of distortion. Let's reduce a bit the volume. Yeah, it's not loud at all. The speaker is live at high voltage, huh? Maximum volume again. No tricks, it's connected to the high voltage input. No other wires. Let's change the music. Oh, too much distortion. Pausa. Play. But there's a way to increase the volume. Okay, the way to increase the volume is to use an output transformer from a tube TV. This is for an PCL86 4 ohms output. This apparently has way more tunes for the primary. Same setup, same adjustments. Again, no other wires. The speaker now is an 8 ohms speaker instead of a 25 ohms one, pretty rare speaker. And let's give some music. Now the volume is higher. Let's reduce the volume for a bit less of distortion. This thing is live, I can't touch it. Even the speaker. And effects. That's cool. You can see the meter moving because there's a positive drive of the grid 1, so it drives more current when the volume increases. You can hear my voice compared to the speaker, but it's not loud, sorry. I hoped for more, but that's it. Probably with a specifically designed transformer, it will make more sound. It will be louder, but not in this case. Same setup of the driving of the voltages again with the flyback. Kind of 15-20 kilovolts of HT voltage. And the focus grid put at maximum to spread the rings as much as possible. And the screen grid instead is just above minimum because too much and grid 1 behaves oddly, and too low and the sound is a bit lower. Pause, play, pause, play. I can't touch this thing, it's live. Even the speaker is live at high voltage, at kinda 20 kilovolts. This is the simplest solution. Okay. So, thanks for having watched my video, and next time I'm gonna show you how to use an hair dryer as oscilloscope. I promise to you. Okay, bye.